Hello Internet, and welcome to this multi-part guide to the configuration options of the FragTrade trading bot. In this video I'm going to give you a high-level overview of the configuration options for your bot to do automatic trading. At first I thought that one video was enough to discuss the different options to set up your bot besides the strategy that you want to use. However, as I read more and more, I realized that one video would just be too long and also maybe a little bit too confusing. So I decided to cut this information up in multiple videos so that it can still be a little bit bite-sized and also better to consume. This video also contains some information on how the bot uses configurations and which options you have to pass the configurations to the bot itself. But before I continue, first a warning. This is edutainment and I am not responsible for faulty setups and possible losses of money as a result of these setups. It is always wise to read the FragTrade website and do your own research on the configuration options. I am not native English, as you probably know by now, so I could be wrong on my interpretation of some of the explanations given on the website. I always test my configuration first with a dry run of at least a month, and then, if I am confident enough, I will use this setup in real trading. So, now that this is out of the way, let's continue with the agenda for this video. In this video I will show you the process of creating a new config file with a command line. And after that I'm going to show you the configuration with a manual start of the bot. I'm also going to explain the ways the bot uses the configurations from different sources and how one source takes prevalence over another. There is also an option to stack multiple configuration files on top of each other, and I'll show you that as well. I use the term stacking, but I read that this is not a term that is used on the FragTrade website, so this is my own term. Finally, I'm going to also give you an overview of the configuration categories or classes that determine how the bot behaves while trading. I'd like to point out that this video will also form the basis for future videos where I will be digging deeper into certain categories of the configuration file. You can expect those videos in the future. Again, I will be using the virtual machine that I have been using in earlier videos. It is a Linux virtual machine with Mint as my distribution, and the information I will give you is also available on the FragTrade website. You can see the link at the bottom of the screen. So, let's begin with creating a configuration file. However, if you watched the first video on how to install FragTrade on your machine, you actually made an initial configuration file for FragTrade during the installation and setup of the FragTrade bot. If you want to create a new one with just the default settings, and you can make the new configuration with the commands shown on this page. You can give it any name, but you have to remember that when you use it when starting the bot, that you have to put it in the config section in that command. In this demonstration, I'm going to create a new configuration file for the FragTrade bot. You can see over here that I'm currently in my home directory. So first of all, I have to change the directory to the one that I installed FragTrade in. And secondly, because this is a newly started terminal, the Python virtual environment has not been started. And you can start it with this command. By the way, these commands are also in my GitHub repository. Now, just enter the command for creating a new config file. And you can see over here that the config file name is newconf. Now you see the questions you have to answer. And I'm just going to use the defaults. No, and also no. And at this moment, the new configuration file has been created for further editing. After we have created the config file, we have to change it so that it will fit our specific situation. The actual editing of the possible parameters will be done in future videos. I do not want to wander off too much in this video, so I will only concentrate on how to use the configuration file itself. On this page, you can see a small overview of the commands that use the config file. In the next part of the video, I will show you how they actually are used. So, let me remove this text file and clear the screen. Okay, let's change the other file. And here you can see the examples I've given you in the last slide. And I'm just going to put these commands in the terminal window and see what's happening. And before I do that, you have to notice that the config file I just made is not the config file I'm going to use over here, because I have to do some minor tweaks to actually start using these commands. So this is another config file, which is just simply config.json. And if I use this for downloading the backtesting data from some pairs, I'm just entering this. It's for the last 9 days and for 5 minutes time frames. And you see over here that it actually downloaded the data into this directory. The next command I'm going to show you is the backtesting. Again, this is not the config that I made in the last section, but it's config that I made in a previous video, which I also prepared. And let's try to do some backtesting on the backtesting data I just downloaded. I'm not going into the actual strategy of the sample strategy, but you can see over here that it has a profit of 2.5% over the last 9 days. So actually quite good, I think. I will not go further into the hyperoptimization command because I have not configured this yet, but we can do some dry run trading. This means that I'm not actually live trading, but I'm going to do this like, for example, paper trading. And the bot is starting using the exchange Binance. Wallets are synced, markets are downloaded. Okay, let's just wait for the first heartbeat. There's no error, so actually everything is running quite well. Okay, we just now see that there is a status message and a first heartbeat, so everything is working well. Great. There are actually different ways to supply your bot with configuration options. They also have a certain importance when supplying them to your bot. So to start with the highest prevalence, you can give your bot configuration parameters directly through the command line. These parameters override all other parameters, so if you have a parameter set in your configuration file and you start the bot on the command line, then the parameter on the command line will override the one that is written down in the configuration parameter. You can also configure your bot with environment variables, which take a second prevalence when available. Using these variables can actually create some confusion because they are loaded at your session startup and will override settings in the config file. In other terms, when you log on to your system, these fract rate parameters will be directly loaded in memory, and when the bot starts, it will use these parameters instead of the ones that you configured in the config file. So if you're not aware of these possible environment variables or forgot that you once set those ones, then it could give you a big headache, because if your bot does not work the way you want and you cannot pinpoint where the problem lies, then it would be great bug hunting time, so to speak. That's why I don't use these at the moment. The third option to pass on configuration parameters to FractTrade is by using the strategy file. However, not all parameters can be set within the strategy file, only those that are marked with strategy override in the documentation. Those parameters can also be part of your strategy as well. So an example is your stop loss parameter. If you set a generic stop loss in your configuration file and you have a slightly tighter stop loss in your strategy, then that will override the one that is generic in the configuration file. And finally, you can use the configuration file itself, of course. And you can collect all parameters and edit them when necessary in one single file, which is, of course, for management convenient, but sometimes it's also wise to create a second one with, for example, API keys or other secret information. Especially when you want to distribute your configuration file to other people, but you do not want to publish your Exchange API key and secret, then the option for using a second config file is very good. Before we continue, let's clean up the bot. Okay. And go to the next file The first demonstration I'm going to show you is the configuration stacking. Here I have a command which loads the original configuration file, and if I enter it in the terminal window, you will see that Fractorate will load this config file with the configurations I made earlier in another video. And where you have to look out for is the amount of tether that I'm going to use for trading. So here it's 100 USDT, and also that I am loading the sample strategy. The second file which I'm going to load can be used for super secret information like your API keys, but also if you do not want to edit your original configuration file, you can set some other specific configurations in the second file to test. In this file I changed the amount of tether to use to 1000. So if I'm going to start the bot and I load both files, you will see that the second file has more preference over the first file, and the amount of tether, here 100, will be higher. And you see, now I have a 10,000. Okay, now clean this up and do the second demonstration. And in this demonstration, I want to show you how environment variables can make things a little bit more tricky and what the effect is on the bot. And you saw earlier that the second config file had a stake amount of 10,000. So I'm going to change this to 999. And now let's see which of the two amounts will take preference over the other. So just start the bot again. And let's see what's happening. Okay, let me check where's the stake amount. And now you can see over here that the environment variable takes prevalence over the second configuration file. Let's continue to the last demonstration. But before we're going to do that, first we have to remove the environment variable which we set up earlier. So before we do that, I just use this command to check if there are environment variables for Fractorate available in memory, and you can see here that it actually is. And to remove that, we're going to use the unset command. And after this, you can see that there is no environment variable left, so the stake amount should not be 999, but again the one from the second configuration file, which is over here. Let's clear this up. And for the last demonstration, I want to show you that the command line always overrides all the previous way for entering configuration parameters. So if I have a configuration file over here, and I made a small error in this file. So the configuration file had set the simple strategy, as I can remember, but if I want to override the simple strategy with another one, I can just use the strategy parameter on the command line itself. So let's check if I am correct. Using the original configuration file and using a new strategy parameter. And we should see over here, yes, that's correct. Here you see the new strategy instead of the original simple strategy which was given in the configuration file. And this sums up my demonstration for this video, so let's continue. And finally, I want to show you my personal overview of the configuration sections that you have to think about. Each category contains its own parameter set around a specific part of the bot's behavior. I personally always like to have a high-level overview of what to think about concerning the options and settings of software, and Fractorate is no different to me. I clustered the different settings in the following categories. Money management settings. It's not an exact term, but it gives me the feeling that I have some control of how much money I put into a trade. So it's the most exact term I could find for myself. You also have the strategy override parameters. These parameters will probably be discussed when I start making videos about strategy development and backtesting later on. There are also the interface settings, and these interface settings are connected to Telegram bots, webhooks and API servers. The buy and sell settings determine how the order book will be used when buying assets or selling assets. And the exchange settings discuss the different exchange parameters which you can set up. And there is also a category of backtest settings where you can play with some backtest parameters for backtesting, of course. So, to wrap things up, there's a lot of ground to cover, and I hope that you will find this interesting enough to watch my future videos for it. I would like to thank you for watching this video. Please click the like button, subscribe to my channel, and click the notification bell to get updated on new videos. If you'd like to have a certain fract trade subject covered in one of my future videos, please leave a comment and I'll do my best to make one in the future. Again, thank you for watching.